And that's hot sauce. What's it called? That's, anyways, it's really good. Nonetheless, all I know is I went home to drop off the kids, and Mary was cooking. I've been with the kids over the house and the nachos to be able to cook. And they tasted really, really good. So Steve's going to send you guys an email with the link tomorrow. You can watch it and make your own tacos. Okay, again, it was a vegetarian taco dish. It was pretty cool. And you drive me nuts because I can't think of the word. Tomorrow is a cool talk. We have Grey Cup head quarterback, CFL player, Zach Claris. He's going to be on the talk, which is really cool. He's going to be talking about his history, who he is, how he got to the level he is at, right? Playing for the Winnipeg team in the CFL. They won the Grey Cup last year, so that's pretty cool. He's laughing at me right now.
Because he doesn't know the name of the team?
Anyways, he's going to be sharing his experience, his principles of success, again, if the buddy want to be successful in work, sport, anything else. I'm sure it's going to be the same principles that we hear time and time again, but it's cool to hear from a professional athlete, not just a CrossFit, right? So he's going to be giving up his time to share his story with us, which is being awesome at 12 o'clock. So try to tune in if you have time. We're also going to be doing it live on Instagram. So we're going to do it through Zoom and Instagram at the same time. So again, if you want access to Zoom for whatever reason, you can go on Instagram and watch as well. That being said, today we're going to be working on similar to what we did last week, but there's going to be no tempo, right? So we're taking away the tempo, but we're increasing the volume of reps. This way you can start getting used to moving at your own tempo with the overhead squats that we've been working on. Okay, so what we're going to do right now, we're going to get into this position for me. Hopefully you can see me okay. Good. All the way in here right now. Open up, just to turn on your core. We're just going to get into that plank position. And we're going to rock back and forth on our tippy toes, back and forth. As you get comfortable, as your wrists get more flexible, you lean more and more forward. Okay? My goal, which is not going to happen, but I want to think positively anyways, and I'm going to lean so far forward my nose can touch the floor. Right? Yeah. Not going to happen, but I'm just working on it. So make sure you guys are rocking back and forth. Elbows are locked, shoulder blades are spread apart. Just turn on your core. And I want you to lean as far forward as you can and hold. Hold that position, squeeze your bum, hold. Keep it going. Keep holding. Keep those shoulder blades spread apart, shoulder blades down. Keep it going. Keep leaning more forward if you can. And relax. All right, so what we're going to do, we're going to lie on floors. I lied, that made no sense. We're going to lie on our backs. We're going to bring our knees up like this. We're going to straighten our right leg down. I'm going to reach over with my left leg, trying to keep it at 90 degrees. And my back arm, so my left arm, if you have poor mobility, it's probably going to be raised up like this. Okay? So what I want to do is keep this knee where it is and rotate my upper body down to the ground. So my left hand is touching, I'm turning my left elbow and my left shoulder. Okay? So I'm just trying to get everything down there. I'm trying to stretch my chest, my shoulders, increase my T-spine mobility, okay? So try to make sure everything's touching. Beautiful. Cool. Big deep breaths. Low, come back to the center. And what I'm going to do is bring my left leg, reach over, Yeah. Your shoulders, your right shoulder's probably going to raise up. We're trying to bring it down to the ground. Rotate, press down. Best we can. Hold it there. Take a deep press. Relax, we'll keep together. All right, so what are you going to do now? We're going to get on all fours. Like this. One hand behind my head. You bring it in. Look in the direction of rotating. Rotate as much as I can. And bring it back down. We're going to do 2 sets of 5 reps, okay? I don't want you guys swinging like this. Right, when you feel you have that in the ring, I want you to push the boundary. You really try to push and see if you rotate anymore. The chances are you'll hit the top for like 2 or 3 seconds, okay? We're gonna do 5 reps with your right arm. Ready? Go. Number 2 sets each side, okay? And 2 sets of 5 each side. So what I'm going to do next, once you guys are done, you're going to stay on your knees. We're going to do a close grip push up from here. I'm going to bring my shoulders as far forward as I can and try to get my forearms, okay, as vertical as possible to the ground. Okay, so I'm putting myself in a more vulnerable position than I typically would. My shoulders are down, right? So I'm lengthening my bicep in the front of my belt a lot more than I typically would, and to acquire a little bit more wrist flexibility. So from here, I'm walking up, okay? I want everyone on their knees. As far forward as you can, walk up. One more, all the way down. Walk it. Very good. So what I want to see you guys do here is we're gonna go 40 seconds, as many push-ups as you can, okay? I want you to start off going with the biggest set possible, all right? Once you've done that, then obviously you're gonna survive for however much time is left. If you're like Chris, 40 seconds is easy, I can go unbroken. Try to do 100 reps in 40 seconds, right? Just to get the idea, then you're pushing, you're gonna go as fast as you can. Chest touch the ground, elbows locked up, okay? Then you should be reaching a lot more than you typically would. For those of you who can do it on your like on your toes, I don't want you to do that. I want you to go on your knees, and I want you to focusing on going over farther than you typically would, right? So I want you to reach as far as you could. If you're like, I've never done that before, that's pretty much what I want you to work on, okay? So you're gonna work on speed, well, volume and speed, all right? We got 40 seconds, as many push-ups as you can. Everybody's on your knees, right? timer, which is one more. Hold on. You have 10 seconds, okay? Three, two, one, let's go. Let's go back. Fast as many reps as you can. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Keep going. Chest touch the ground, all the way up. We're already halfway done, guys. Let's go. Nice and fast. Nice and fast. Let's go. Big set. Let's go. Go on. Let's go. Let's go. Keep it up. Keep it up. 8 seconds and we're done. Let's go. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Time. All right, guys. Stand up. Shake it up. Very good. So what I want you to do, is you're going to get into the bottom of the squat for me. Okay? So, shoulders apart, toes down, knees out, put your hands on the inside of your legs. Because it's in the bottom, it's a bit comfortable. You're going to rotate side to side. Get your hips nice and mobile. All the way down. Push those knees up. Good. Stand up. Shake it out. So what I want you to do next, you're going to put your feet a little bit wider than where you were just at right now. Okay? So same thing. Toes out, knees out, but we just went a little bit wider than before. We're going to still try to get to the bottom of that squat. Pushing those knees out, opening up those hips. And you're right side to side. Very good. All right, we're going to stand right up. You put one hand up in the air. Put it behind your body or behind your ear. Okay, knees are back. Behind your ear, elbows locked. So I'm thinking about hyperextending that elbow. Okay, and right here, you'll notice that this is what wants to happen because I'm kind of tight. I'm going to push that rib cage down, squeeze my bum. I'm going to squat all the way down and I'm going to hold it. All right, ready, hands up, elbows locked. And rib cage down, squat straight down. Pull. Touch the ground. If you can with that other hand, then down. Touch the ground. Stand. One more. Down. Get those elbows locked. Come on. Stand. Relax. Other arm. Extend that elbow. Make sure it's behind your ear. And close. I want to see you doing this, right? Torso straight. Put the cage down so you bump. And down. Push those knees right out. Make sure you feel your butt turned on. Stand. Drive those knees right out. Down. Stand. Ready, one more, and down. And stand. All right. Let's talk about the work that we're going to do today. We're going to be doing overhead squats. One arm. We're going to start off with our right arm. We're going to be doing 8 to 12 reps. You can grab a weight, and you can grab Steve's lunchbox. You can dump a bag somewhere else. All right. And there's food in here. All right, so again, if you have a double bag, I kind of like it because it's going to actually force me to bring that arm back anyways. So instead of having to worry about bringing my arm back, I have to focus on making sure that elbow is locked. Okay, so I'm here, I'm down, and up. Okay, Okay, you can also use a dumbbell, you can use a plate, you can use a barbell. Whatever floats your boat, whatever you have accessible to you, okay? So 8 to 12 reps with your right arm. Minute 2, we're going to be doing loop bridges 25 seconds each leg. So start with left leg in the air, extend as high as you can, control it down, extend as high as you can. The biggest issue I see with most people is that they think this is extension because they're flexing high enough, hard enough, right? I want it fully extended where you're driving your leg all the way back. It's like physically impossible to go any higher. Okay? Down and up. The first set, use your hands to press into the ground. It's giving you more kinetic energy to bring your hips up higher. Okay? So it's good because it's going to help create a connection with your brain and let you understand where you are in space. So that means you can bring your hips up higher than you typically would, all right? So if we do it the first 1 to 2 sets, at least your body's understanding where you are in space, they can try to pop it up a little bit, I have another inch I can go. So by the second and third set, you don't need to use your hands, hopefully, okay? But again, you might not even need to use your hands at all, so use it as a tool if needed, or if I call you up and I say use your hands, okay? So that's minute 2. 25 seconds each leg. We do glute bridges. Minute number 3, we're in the squat, 8 to 12 reps with our left arm. Minute 4, we're just going to do regular planks. Okay? So I'm holding here. If I want to make it more difficult, pick up the leg. If I want to make it more difficult, pick up the leg and an arm. Okay? Let me know if you have any questions, please. Okay, no, good. I don't know if it's a bad idea. Well, I'm going to give you advice or opinion. Do you want me to play music or do you want to hear me? Because if I put on the music, you can't hear me because the headphones are kind of messed up. You guys want music? Give me a thumbs up. If you want me to talk, give me a thumbs down. You guys like me, eh? You want me to talk? Okay. Well, thank you. You're pretty good about myself. Oh, and sorry, guys, I forgot to mention, happy Mother's Day to all those mothers out there that I didn't have a copy yesterday. Happy Mother's Day. Hope you guys are spoiled. Yeah. All right, guys, let's get started, okay? Steve, you ready? Wait for the special effects coming up in a second.
Oh, wrong person.
Come on, Steve, forgot.
Shit.
There it is. Oh, we see you.
I know. There you go. You're good.
There we go. Look at that. Super professional. All right. 10 seconds, okay? Three, two, one. All right, let's go. 8 to 12 reps. Elbows locked. Drive those knees right out, everybody. Right out. Very good. Keep that chest right up. Keep looking up. That's it. Let those knees come forward, everyone. Great job, guys. Great job. 8 to 12 reps. Don't worry about rushing the pace, right? I care about how low you're getting. I want you to have confidence. I want you to have control. Good job. Again, once we're done with this, remember your goal is to make sure that your hips are fully extended and you can't bring them any more forward on this next part. Okay, we got 7 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, let's go. Let's go, let's go. Don't worry about rushing it. We're going to be in control. The same tempo up and down. So this way you're engaged the whole time. Keep going. High as you can, everyone. Try to make sure it's your glutes. It's not your hamstrings or your quads working. High. And switch legs, please. Keep Keep it up, guys. Keep it up. Nice and high. All right, that's time. Good. We're going to stand up. We're going to go left arm. 3, 2, 1. All right, let's go. Elbows locked. Good, guys. Very good. Keep those elbows locked. Good. Good job, Natalie. Thanks, Jess. Good. That's it, Al. I've never seen you squat so low before. That's amazing. Good job. Ivana, lock those elbows while you're not in your basement. Good job. I'm so jealous you guys are working out. I don't work out today. It's disgusting. I hate that song. All right, so what we're going to do in 10 seconds. We're going 50 second plank, okay? And again, if you want to make it difficult, you can pick up a leg and an arm if you want as well. All right, let's go. Let's go. That's it, hold it, everyone. Let's hold it. Get lower than what you feel comfortable with. Drive those knees forward. Now's the time to get comfortable with, right? Because it's not super heavy. Unless you're needed, because that looks really heavy. Those elbows locked. Elbows locked. Head up. Head up. Good job, Alan. Great. If you feel comfortable with the glute bridge and you're like, Chris, my hips are as high as they can be and I'm feeling it. Put the weight on your hips, you can add some tension out there as well. All right, let's go. Start with pressing with the right leg. On the way down, I want it just as controlled as you are up. Okay, don't just let it go. You want to build that tension for 25 seconds. Keep going. All right, let's switch it up, please. That's it. Very good. Time. Time. Good. All right, so we're going to go left arm. Okay, let's go. Left arm, let's go. Lock it up high. That's it. Drive those knees right out. Keep that chest upright. Rib cage down. If you can keep that rib cage down and keep your core tight while doing it, it might seem like a lot at the beginning, but you're going to feel a lot more control. Good, guys. Great job. Good job, Vanessa. That's it. Let those arms go back, Ivana. Good job, guys. 15 seconds. Three, two, one. All right, guys, plank. Let's go. Chipotle. That's what I was talking about. The tacos, I know you guys don't know what I'm saying. There was a Chipotle lime mushroom tacos, that's what she made. I got her number, you got me enough. Chipotle. Make sure you win the sauce and the crab. Oh, not that you guys care. I don't have to. Seven seconds. Keep it there, guys. Keep it there. Come on. Nine. Awesome. All right. Let's get ready. We got that right arm. Okay. Do you feel that 8 to 12 reps is easy? Slow down the tempo. Slow down or up. All right. If you don't have any weight. I'm sure that's not the case for most of you because it's such a challenging movement, but if it is easy for you, keep that chest as upright as you can. Don't look down, you're going to fall forward. Drive those knees right out as we're going down. Out, out, out. Don't turn on your butt, squeeze your butt all the way up. Get that depth. Let's see it, Johnson. Get low, come on. Let those knees come forward. Good job, Nancy. Good job. All right, we got 3 seconds. All right, let's go, guys. Squeeze your butt. Nice and high. Really, really, really high. Come on. Good, Rachel. Nice and high. That's really good. Come on. Let's see you go a little higher, Joe. That's good, Ivana. Control it all the way down. Good sides. Don't rest on the ground, Cat. Keep that tension the whole time you're gone. All right, time. Get ready for that left arm. All right, and go. Let's go. Let's go, guys. Come on. Keep that rib cage down, guys. I know you want to get comfortable and do this to get more space, but if you get in the habit of this, it's going to make a huge difference keeping it down, especially when you're lifting with heavy weight overhead. One, three, that is automatic positioning you need to put yourself in. Good. All right, so you got planks. And 5 seconds. Go, let's go, 50-second plank. Jessica, one plank. Plank. Okay, I'm the only one who saw you, don't worry. Everyone's doing planks, they can't see. If it's easy for you, one arm in the air, just like Jill was. Not intentionally, I saw that. You have 20 seconds left. Which again, you want to make it difficult for the last couple of seconds. Put one foot in the air, one arm in the air. Two legs in the air. Come on. Let's go. One and pat. Good, guys. We have one last set of everything. And then we can talk about today's workout. And let's go. Right arm. Start squatting. Nice and low. Let's see it, Mikey. Nice and deep, buddy. Good. Keep that head up, Bobby G. Head up, buddy. Keep looking at me. Good. Awesome, everyone. Keep it going, keep it going. Very good, very good. That's really good, Nancy. All right, we got 8 seconds. And remember, on the way up and the way down, you're keeping the same tempo. I don't want you to splash it up and then bring it down, right? I want the same tempo. Let's go. Start pressing with the right leg. Stem as high as you can and control it all the way down. Good, good job there. That's good, Jeff. Good. Good job, man. I'll go a little higher than now if I can. Switch sides, everyone. My bad. Keep going, keep going. That's it. You're killing that, Milo. Keep it up, buddy. Got good transform. All right, that's time, everyone. Okay, that's fine. Let's see it.
Like that, huh? Here? It's supposed to be like a cradle.
Top. Keep down, keep down, come on, keep down. Stop me from rotating as well. Good. Let's go up the clock, Captain, come on. Set of planks for the work. 3, 2, 1, let's go, guys. Let's make this challenging, okay? Start with your one leg up for like 20 seconds and then switch legs if you can. Even though I'll tell you what it is every 20 seconds. Okay. I'll try best. Good. Hold, hold, hold. Come on, make it challenging. All right, we're 20 seconds in. Switch legs. One leg on arm. We have 25 seconds left. Three, two, one, time. All right, guys, take a break. Grab some water while I talk about today's workout. Okay, guys, so today's workout. You know, it's 2 minutes on, 1 minute off. So what does that mean? That means you are going as hard as you effing can. Okay? For 2 minutes. 2 minutes work, 1 minute rest. Okay? We're going to be, the buy-in is 20 duffel bag or weighted bellows press. All right? 20 reps, that's a shit ton. Okay? So it might seem like, oh, like, you may not have thought about it, but 20, think of 20 burpees, 20 weighted burpees is what it is, right? So it's going to get spicy. Some of you might not even get to the max reps of back second lunges, and that's okay. Don't try to light the rope, just stick with the devil's press. You try to do as many as you can. just to give you some food for thought, 20 sets, oh, sorry, 20 reps for 5 sets, that's 100 devil's breaths. That's a lot. Okay, I'm not trying to scare you, but I was watching the class today doing it, and I'm like, oh my God, this is awful. I love it. All right, so 20 devil's breaths. So what does that mean? You're going to grab your breath away, jump down, jump up. As you jump up, you're going to bring your feet wider than your weight, right? So jump up. My back is flat, driving through my heels, extend my hips, all the way up, back down. Down, up, flat back, drive through my heels, bring it up. Okay? If you have a dumbbell, which is, you see the dumbbell? Oh, right there. Give me 1 second. If you have a dumbbell, you can also do it with one arm, right? So I'm here. Take it down, pick it up with one arm, grab through my heels, extend your breaths, back down, alternate, down, up. Or you can do it, if you have a dumbbell that's too heavy to do with one arm, just hold it like this, right? So you jump up to this position, flat back, grab through my heels, extend up, back down. Just make sure I'm holding down, don't get lazy. Don't just that, right? Think about keeping your spine straight. Think about thinking. As I go down, I push my hips back to counterbalance the weight here. Okay? By doing that, it'll allow me to keep my muscles fresh. Right? If I just go right down, it's going to fry out my erectors and I'm just going to burn out. You're going to have to feel the first 2 rounds, or round 4 or 5. All those little tiny muscles being tired, we don't want that, okay? Because you want our spine to be rigid. A whole lot of other people just using our hamstrings all the way down to load that weight. Okay, so as tired as we're getting, don't get lazy with it and roll your back up or down. If you have a hard time with the burpees and you have a hard time with the pace, stepping down and stepping up is also okay, all right? Do what you can, do the best you can. You can do a little bit of both if you need to. So I don't know how aggressive are the lunges waiting. Yeah, I haven't gone to the wind lunges yet, but I'll get to that now. So do you have any questions with the devil's press before I move on? No. Okay, perfect. So the lunges are not waiting, okay? You're gonna step back, vertical shins, step up, plant, down, up. All right? So, yeah, 2 minutes on, 1 minute off. You're going ham. Okay? You better go fast. You'll start to see your first set is going to be like your, you call it your learning set. You're like, holy shit, I wasn't fast enough. By the time you finish that round, you have a good idea of, you know, how fast you're going to have to go if you want to finish the devil's press. Okay, so 2 minutes on, 1 minute off, 20 rep buy-in, max reps of max 7 lunges. For this, I'm going to take off the volume and throw on the music. You'll hear me chirping in probably the last 10 seconds where we'll run the music and I'll just yell at you a little bit. But yeah, you're not going to hear my voice during this part. Just know you've got to start off hard. The first 30 seconds, okay? Give me a thumbs up if we're good. Good, good, good. Awesome. Thank you. All right, guys, let's get ready. You guys good? Awesome. 10 seconds. Three, two, one. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on. Ready, back. Very good. We'll be right back.
just a man and his will to survive. So many times it happens too fast. You trade your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight.
Catching your breath on those burpees is the devil's press. You gotta pick a point where you know you're gonna catch your breath for that split second, okay? It's either right at the bottom or in that locked up position. Okay, if you keep it consistent, you're gonna be consistent, obviously. You'll allow you to control yourself instead of trying to catch your breath at all different angles. So if you think of every time you ground, take a split second breath, pause for a split second here, it's gonna keep you a lot better and you're gonna be a lot more focused when you do it. Ready? We got 3 seconds, guys. And let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Come on! Only 6 minutes of work left for today, we're done. So that's good. All right, 10 seconds, everyone. Three, two, one. Go, let's go, let's go, come on.
to tell me what this is all about?
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking, or you and your homies might be lying to chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta low. As they croak, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of G the little homies wanna be like. On my knees in the night, saying prayers in the streetlight.
Been spending most of my life.
You guys don't care right now. But what do you think about that little background thing that Steve did? Does it look cool? A little worldly thing? Does it look professional? It comes up to you like, no. Oh, wow. I don't see that. All right. 15 seconds. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, guys, let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
I used to believe we were running on the edge of something beautiful, something beautiful. Selling a dream, smoking mirrors keep us waiting on a miracle, on a miracle.
Good job.
going to happen, but it's going to work, and you can go as hard as you can. You can't slack it through the workout. You can slack for about 10 seconds, and then you work out. It's good. I'm sure you guys are on the lunges, which is great. And you guys all look like you're hurting right now, so we know we're doing something right. All right, 5 seconds, guys. Last round. All right, let's go, let's go, let's go, guys. Come on. Switch legs. So back the elbow. Just chill out. So excited. Here, please. Now, yeah, up to the ground, move it. Good Bring the feet to the front. Each of those goes. If you're comfortable, walk your hands down to your heels. Bring one leg in. Rotate your glutes for me. And again, guys, just reminding you, tomorrow on Instagram and Zoom, bring up that quarterback. We will break up the CFL.
What team?
Zach Barrows. Sorry?
What team?
Wait, you want to break up, actually. Yeah, if you have a football fan or whatever, it's a cool time to get into the passing specific questions and then you answering whatever question you have. Thanks. Relax. Good job today. Hope you enjoyed it. And enjoy it. We'll see you again tomorrow. Thank you very much, everyone. See you. See you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thanks. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Gotta try it.
Hey?
No, I gotta try like turning this on and off or something.
Later, Chris.
See you, Kev.
it's my charger for my Wii.